possible that pouring more water into a bowl reduces the maximum amount of water in the bowl. In a standard epidemiology model, where the fraction infected peaks and then goes down, is it possible that deliberately infecting a fraction of the population early reduces the peak of the epidemic? If the water slowly leaks from the bottom of the bowl, then no. And if the model is the standard epidemiology one, then also no. Compartmental epidemiology models, like the standard susceptible infected recovered models, assume that the disease duration is exponentially distributed. This is unrealistic. Disease duration cannot be longer than the human lifetime, and cannot be shorter than the response time of the immune system. Real disease duration is bounded below and above, and is single-peaked. If the disease duration is exponentially distributed, then the pool of infected people is like a bowl with no outflow over the edge. Pouring more water in always raises the maximum amount of water in the bowl, just like infecting more people early in an epidemic always raises the peak number infected in a standard epidemiology model. However, real disease duration is bounded in a narrow interval. In that case, waves of inflow into the pool of infected people create waves of outflow, like water sloshing out over the edge of the bowl. In that case, pouring more water into the bowl rapidly may result in a lower peak amount of water in the bowl than pouring a smaller amount in slowly. Just like infecting a fraction of the population early may mean that these people recover by the time the epidemic reaches its peak, and then they dilute the pool of susceptible people, resulting in a lower peak number infected for the epidemic. If the disease duration is finite, then infecting a fraction of the population early means that after the disease duration they get well, so the fraction infected jumps down by the same amount that it initially jumped up. This replaces one high peak of the epidemic, under no intervention, with two lower peaks if a fraction of the population is infected early as part of this medical intervention. Having two lower peaks may be beneficial instead of one high peak if the main concern is to avoid overwhelming medical resources. If the medical resource boundary at which it gets overwhelmed is between the heights of the two peaks, then the two lower peaks do not overwhelm the resources, but the one high peak does. This is similar to how throwing more water into a bowl faster reduces the maximal amount of water in the bowl, because some of the water exits by the time the rest arrives.